optimizing your profile on whichever platform you are present and you want to leverage for your personal brand. Optimize it, because if it is not optimized, you will not get good results. And what I mean by optimizing your platforms, first of all, put your own DP, your own face. Do not put your brand logo. There are lots of people, they put their brand logo, their company logo in place of their DP, even if on LinkedIn. See, you are making human to human connections. You are not making logo to logo connection or business to business connections. Your face value can generate more brand equity for your business rather than your logo. Please remember this. Okay. So put your own DP. That will give you more leverage, right? So first of all, your DP on Facebook, you can use casual DP, but on LinkedIn, always use professional headshot. Okay, there should not be any background and casual picture. Please use only close-up and headshot picture, right? Then second thing is cover page. That's most visible to your visitors, and many of us do not put anything on cover page. Let me tell you, your cover page tells your story, and it takes only 2 to 3 seconds for people to make an impression about you on social media. If they don't like your profile, if it is not leveraged, they will not connect with you, and they will have a bad impression about you, like you are not serious about using these platforms. So make a good impression with great cover page and DP. So what you can put on cover page: about your business, what services you are giving, and about your personality as well, right? Your personality, like your leading thoughts, what defines, some quotations that defines your personality, like if I say be your best, be unique. So there are many people who write the quotations that defines their personality. So you can write that quotation. You can write about your business, products, services, their features, how you are helping people. So there may be many things that can define you in one line. You can put there, right? So please use your cover page. In fact, if nothing, at least you can put the pictures of your products. You can put the pictures of your programs. If you are training people, if you are helping people, if you are speaking in gathering. So it can be anything you put there, so that it builds instant credibility of your profile. Okay? Optimizing your profile, DP, cover page. Second thing is, at least complete all the details, the space provided by these platforms. I have seen many people, they have not completed the entire details. You know, if you have not completed the entire details, your profile goes downstream. It will not come into search. And even if people search it, they will not have a good, your profile will not have a good impact on their mind. Because understand this thing, there are only 3 to 5 seconds to make an impression with your digital profile before people scrolls to another profile. Such as if someone is looking for personal branding expert on LinkedIn, right? They will search personal brand expert in Delhi NCR or somewhere. Then my profile pops up and there is no cover page, no good DP, nothing I have written about my bio, nothing. Do you think they will click and check about you? Then your effort goes waste. You will not come into search. People will not want to connect with you. Even if you send the request to someone, they will not accept. And then you think, why they are not accepting? So how would you grow your network if your profile is not optimized, right? So every platform provides that one-liner headline about you. So if you can define yourself into one line, that is called your brand statement. Okay, if you read my brand statement on LinkedIn, how I define myself, it is just simply written: I help entrepreneurs build their personal brand and leverage their digital presence. So in one line, I tell about myself. So can you define yourself into that one line? That's your personal brand statement. So write your personal brand statement. Second thing is about your elevator pitch. Every platform provides some space, like LinkedIn, like Facebook. On Facebook page, there is a story section where you can put about you in some words, maybe 200 to 25 words. Do not make it more lengthy. That's your elevator pitch. On LinkedIn, your summary is your elevator pitch. So write about you if you can define yourself into those 250 to 300 words, because people do not have much time to read about you, right? So just prepare your elevator pitch and put there. And you always have to have your website so that you can divert the people to your website who want to know more about your story, more about your business, your services. So website is the secondary thing that you need to have where you will divert your audience, right? So DP, cover page, your elevator pitch, your brand statement, and your some media photographs. LinkedIn provides the space where you can put some media, maybe your business presentation, your program pictures, your certification. You can put the media into your summary. Similarly for Facebook, there is a section called featured section. I have seen many people use their personal photographs there. Do not use their personal photographs because it is visible to everyone available on Facebook. Anyone. So please do not use your personal photographs on feature section. You cannot hide them from public, right? So what kind of photograph you can use there? Your business photographs, your pictures photograph. Like I have put my book picture, right? Evolve as a brand, my book. And then I have put my workshop upcoming events photograph, my workshop photographs. Use only public pictures there. Do not use your personal pictures. But do not leave that section blank, because if I search you and I'm not connected with you, this is the only section where you can tell people about you before they connect with you, right? So use that features photo feature section and complete each and every detail in your profile. Otherwise people will not know about you. And please do not make it so boring and writing lots of things about you. Just prune it, just concise it in as minimum as you can. You can share about you in minimum words. That is always better, right? If you can tell about yourself into 250 words and even one-liner statements, that's always better on digital platform to build your online reputation. Do not let people read lots of things about you, because they will not read. They are not so interested in us until unless they actually want to go for our services. But yes, if they actually have decided to buy your product and services, they will see everything about you, your website, your Facebook page, your LinkedIn. They will search your credibility. They want to know how good you are doing on two online platforms before they buy. So that time, if they're interested, then they will see. But if you want to reach wider area of audience, wider audience, then tell about yourself into as minimum words as possible. Right, so optimizing your platform, I have told you these steps you have to take care into your notice while you create your profiles. And yes, this is quite funny that people write on LinkedIn, instead of their name, they write their profession. Like if I use Nidhi Tyagi, personal brand coach, on my personal account. See, on business page, it's okay. If you see my Facebook page, it's Nidhi Tyagi, personal brand coach and social media coach, right? It's okay. But if I use that into my personal account, how does it look? Please do not mix your personal profession every time. It does not look good. And do not over-commercialize your personal account. There's a different way to direct your audience from personal to professional. But do not try to always mix them up and make it, and you always try to commercialize your personal account. So please, it should be only your name, your simple name. Nidhi Tyagi is the name. So Nidhi Tyagi personal brand is not my name, right? So please use only your name. Simple, just your name and surname, and do not use a professional name there, right?